Hey everybody, I'm Erica, I come from Colombia. I've been living in Madrid already for 8 years and I'm responsible of all of the hostel activities here in Safe State Madrid. So whenever you come back here, I will show you for sure the city and all of the touristic spots. But in the meantime, I will give you a lot of recommendations of what to do. Okay, so here are my recommendations of places to go to drink. In Spain is everything about the plazas, the terraces. There's really nice weather here always. So one plaza that I definitely have to go is Plaza Santa Ana. There is always something going on 365 days of the year. You will find terraces and also you will find clubs open until 6 a.m. So really nice. Other place, it will be in Malasaña neighborhood. The plaza is Dos de Mayo and it's a very urban cultures neighborhood, very bohemian, so you can find a lot of people playing guitars and it's a really nice atmosphere. Other place, it will be La Latina, and right there they have one street that is called Cava Baja and it's full of tapas places, also for getting a really nice wines, vermouths, cañas, of course, that is beer in Spain. So definitely that place you should go. And for the party people, we have here the biggest nightclub in Madrid and the second one biggest in Europe, that is called Capitol. It has 7 floors. It was a theater before. Each floor has different music, so for sure if you're looking for party, you're gonna have a lot of fun there. And of course, last but not least, it will be here in Safe Stay Madrid. You have a really nice terrace and also the speakeasy downstairs. Really nice cocktails. They have also live music sometimes. And well, the atmosphere here is great and also the view is just amazing. So you should see it. Regarding places to eat, guys, I will definitely suggest you one place that is close from Safe State Madrid. It's called La Bodega de Ardoza. It's open since 1892, so long time ago. It's very typical in Madrid. You're gonna see the decoration and the atmosphere of the place. Definitely you have to try the Spanish omelette, okay? La tortilla de patata, for me, the best one in Madrid. Another place, it will be definitely the San Miguel market. I have to suggest you this market. It's very famous. You can find tapas from all over Spain. You have a lot of different desserts as well, seafood. You find everything there. And yeah, for sure, for getting some wines to go with more people and everything, really nice. Another place definitely is one place that I like a lot. It's very small, but it's very Spanish decoration. They put like some flamenco songs as well. The food is great. Lot of different tapas as well from Spain. It's called La Perejila. La Perejila. The street is Cava Baja. That place for sure is, if you're in La Latina, pass around that place. It is nice. And then the last one but not least, it will be Rosy La Loca. It's a restaurant. They're really nice paella. For me, the paella from there is just the best, okay? So definitely all of those places, you're gonna get good options. And then the places that you have to see in Madrid. Guys, you have to know that Spain is a beautiful country. Wherever you go, north, south, is a beautiful country. And of course, the Spanish capital, nevertheless. So one place that you have to go is the Royal Palace of Madrid. It's the largest royal palace in Western Europe. It was built in the 1700s and it's still intact. It's authentic. It's not reconstructed or recreating. It's very neoclassic style building. And then you're gonna see all of the gardens surrounding. It has also a museum, so you can go and learn a lot about the Spanish history. I really suggest it. So definitely one of my favorite places. When people come to my walking tour, they always tell me, and they're amazed about this palace, so I have to tell you guys as well. Other place, it will be Gran Vía. It's a really big avenue, beautiful. The buildings that you see there are just like heartbreaking. And then you have from Plaza España, I suggest to walk all over down Gran Vía until Cibeles. Shopping area as well, so ladies, you know where to go. So definitely a place. Other one, it will be the Retiro Park. It was before one of the gardens of the royal family. It was a gift to one of the queens. And you're gonna see that it's very elegant, very sophisticated at some point. But also it has like beautiful nature. It has a really nice lake, so you can go with friends, rent a canoe. And yeah, just goof around a little bit and do a picnic. Very nice. And then, of course, guys, you have to come to my walking tour, okay? So whenever you come to Madrid, I will take you to these places and to more, okay? We'll show you really nice stuff about this beautiful city. And for all of the Instagram lovers, here are my recommendations of the best places to take Instagram pictures. One place definitely will be Egyptian Temple, El Templo de Voz. From there, the sunset is amazing. The temple is quite nice itself, but it's the view that you have from Madrid, from the cathedral, from the palace, and also the sunset. So, a place to go. Other place, it will be definitely El Palacio de Cristal in Retiro Park. Go there, you'll see why when you get there. It's amazing, the palace is all covered like through crystal, so you can take really nice pictures there for sure. I have like zillions. And then other place, it will be the gardens of the royal palace. You have Sabatini Gardens, and right behind you have also Campos del Moro Gardens. You're gonna find peacocks there. Yeah, really nice decoration with the trees, and well, of course, like the decoration with the palace itself. So those three places definitely will be places that you have to go, and well, just to put jealous to all of your friends in your amazing trip in Spain, and of course the Spanish capital.